Welcome to the Fit Small Business Xero training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to customize invoices, quotes, purchase orders, and receipts in Xero. To follow along with me, log into your Xero account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. You can also click this link to access our full Xero course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. We will use our fictitious company, Acme Web Pros Plus, to demonstrate some concepts. As a business owner, you know the importance of having a good reputation with your customers, suppliers, and anyone else that you may come into contact with. Xero allows you to create professional-looking documents such as a quote or a bid that you may send to a potential customer, an invoice to an existing customer, or a purchase order that you create to place an order with a supplier. The Invoice Settings tab allows you to customize the look and feel of each of these documents, including quotes, purchase orders, and receipts. In addition to the look and feel, you can also set default payment terms, create an automatic reminder to customers once invoices become past due, or set up a reminder a few days before the invoice is due, for example, a due in 7 days reminder. You can also add a payment service link like Stripe or PayPal to invoices so that you get paid faster. Let's take a look at what information is included in the Invoice Settings tab. From the dashboard, you want to go ahead and navigate to the Settings menu and General Settings. Scroll down, right below Features is Invoice Settings. So go ahead and click on that option. There are four key areas to set up within the invoice settings section. We've got the branding theme, default settings, payment services, and invoice reminders. Branding theme. Within the branding theme section, you have the option to add a standard theme or a custom .docx theme. If you go with the standard theme, you can copy an existing theme or create one using Xero's integrated design tools. You can create an unlimited number of standard themes or templates to use on invoices, quotes, purchase orders, and receipts. While the standard theme is pretty easy to use, it is limited to just basic customization like font, logo, and columns to show or hide in a table. If you want the ability to fully customize your templates, then you may want to use the .docx theme. The .docx theme allows you to do full customization using Microsoft Word 2007 or later. In order to use the .docx theme, you should be experienced in using tables and field codes in Word. You can add up to 15 .docx branding themes to apply to invoices, quotes, and purchase orders. In this lesson, we will focus on how to create a standard branding theme. However, you can click the link below this video to find step-by-step instructions on how to create a .docx theme. As I mentioned, you have the option to add a standard theme from scratch here, or copy an existing theme right underneath the options button. You can create one theme that will be used for all invoices, quotes, purchase orders, and receipts, or you can create a different theme for different forms, such as credit notes and statements. So for our example here, we will go ahead and create a standard theme. When creating a standard theme, you want to go ahead and name your brand here in this field. And let's talk about each section here that you can make changes to. Starting with general information, this section covers basic formatting information such as page size, margins, and font size. In the template title section right below that, you can make changes to the name of a form. So for example, if you prefer to use the term estimates instead of quotes, then in the quote title field here, you can simply remove what's there and type in the name of the form that you would like to use. By changing this information here, All quotes that we create going forward will say estimate at the very top of the form instead of quote. This next section here allows you to show information or hide information on the form. If you put a check mark here, the information will show. If you remove the check mark, the information will be hidden. To the right here, we have the ability to select how we want our logo to show up on the form. So you can have it showing to the left, aligned to the left or aligned to the right. You have the ability to determine how you want taxes shown on the form. So showing taxes in an exclusive way will actually have the taxes to show separately on the invoice. Inclusive will have the taxes built into the cost of the items that you are billing for. And right below that, you want to enter your contact address information that you want to appear at the top of the form. Generally, this is going to be the mailing address that you want your customers to use to send payments or other correspondence to you. In the payment services section here, Xero allows you to accept credit card payments from your customers. By adding a payment service, you can easily add a link to your invoices that will allow customers to pay online via credit card. Once you set up your payment account, you will be able to select it from the drop-down menu here so that it will appear on all of your customer invoices. In addition, if you have a PayPal account, you can also connect that to your Xero account and offer it as a payment method to your customers as well. In the Terms and Payment Advice section, this information will appear at the bottom of invoices and statements that are sent to customers. So for example, you can enter instructions to the customer, whether they're paying by check or whether they're paying by credit card. You can provide them with some additional information that they could use. You can also provide additional information or pertinent information that you want to include at the bottom of any quotes that you send to your customers. So once you are done, you want to go ahead and make sure that you save all of your changes. And then we'll move on to the default settings section. There are four primary areas that need to be set up in this section. We've got payment terms, automatic sequencing, outstanding bills, and the quote expiration date. So let's talk about payment terms. Setting up payment terms for both customers and vendors is very important because Xero will use this information to keep track of and remind you when customer invoices are coming due or past due so that you can follow up. By the same token, Xero will also alert you when a bill is coming due or past due so that you can maintain good credit with your suppliers by paying them on time. You can enter the number of days or the date of the month in the field, and then you can select from the following four options. So for bills, for example, we'll go ahead and set the terms for bills to be net 30. And so we'll select 30 days after the bill date, our bills are due. Same thing for sales invoices. We can go ahead and select or enter the number of days after the invoice date. So let's say typically after we send our invoices out, we want to go ahead and have the bill due the 15th, let's say, of the following month. All right. So keep in mind that this information is what applies to most customers and suppliers. So this is the default. However, if you do need to set up a few customers and suppliers with different payment terms, you can do so by entering that information into their contact profile, which we will discuss in the How to Set Up a Customer and Supplier lesson. Click the links below this video to access these lessons. You can also change the payment terms when entering an invoice or when you enter a bill into Xero. So this will be beneficial for special terms that were given just for a specific purchase or sale. We will cover this in more detail in the How to Invoice a Customer and How to Create a Bill lesson. Click the links below this video to access these lessons. Automatic sequencing. Like most accounting software programs, Xero automatically assigns a unique number for each document that you create. The first part of each number indicates the type of document. So for example, for the invoice prefix, the first three letters, INV, indicate that the document is an invoice. Same with credit note. CN is the first two letters of any credit note that you create in Xero. The second part of the number, as you can see here, is numeric. This field will automatically populate to the next available number so that it is never duplicated. If you're converting from another accounting software program and would like to keep your existing numbering system that you have in place, this is where you want to let Xero know what number you would like to start with. So for example, for invoices, let's say that we would like to start our invoice sequencing with invoice number 10,000. So you want to enter that here when we save our changes and go into create an invoice. The very first invoice that you create in Xero will be invoice number 10,000. If you do not have a preference as to the starting sequence of your documents, then you do not need to make any changes to this section at all. Show outstanding bills. By selecting this option here, Xero will include a link on all customer invoices that will take them to a portal and show them a list of all unpaid invoices. Each time your customer makes a payment with Xero Payment Services, the status is updated in real time to paid. We recommend that you include this link because it will keep customers informed of their outstanding balance each time you send them an invoice, which could help you to get paid faster. And finally, quote expiration date. If you send your customers a quote, a bid, or an estimate, then you may want to consider including an expiration date. Setting an expiration date could be beneficial in helping customers to make their decision in a more timely manner, as opposed to dragging it out for months. Similar to the bill and invoice due dates, you can set the expiration date based on the number of days or a specific day of the month, as you can see here. And once we're done, you want to make sure that you save your changes. Payment services. In addition to paying by check, as I mentioned, customers can make payments online with a credit card. In order for you to accept online payments, you must have an existing account with one of the payment services that integrates with Xero, or you can set up an account and then connect it to your Xero account. So we'll go ahead and select the Add Payment Service button here. And here are the payment services that connect with Xero. If you don't have an existing payment account, then you can go ahead and set one up with one of these companies so that you connect it with your Xero account. You can also select the Stripe option, follow the on-screen instructions to set up an account directly within Xero. And let's go back to our invoice settings. And invoice reminders, our fourth and final area here. One of the many benefits of using an accounting software program like Xero is built-in features like invoice reminders that help you to manage the money that your customers owe you, also known as accounts receivable. From within the invoice reminders section, you can set up Xero to automatically email customers after an invoice is past due 7 days, 14 days, 21 days, or you can set up your own reminder. Let's go ahead and set up a reminder for customers and let's be proactive about it. Let's go ahead and set up a reminder where Xero reminds the customer 7 days prior to an invoice's due date. So to do that, we'll go ahead and click the Add Reminder button here. From the drop down here, we want to select Due In. And we're going to put 7 days here in this field. So this is the preset template of what the email will look like that will go to your customer. You can make any changes in this screen, except I would not touch what's in brackets. Xero will automatically populate those areas. But you can make any changes here. So we'll just make one. Okay, and make sure that you save your changes here. And then let's go ahead and save again. That wraps up the lesson on how to customize invoices, quotes, purchase orders, and receipts in Xero. To access our full Xero course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. If you have any feedback about this course or any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.